darker. I see a bit of blue in this, so I've mixed black into the Prussian blue that was already on my palette. Hi, I'm Sarah, and I make art. Today I want to demonstrate how I might paint a particular shade of blonde hair using this reference photo, which is from Pixabay. The first thing I'm doing is wetting the paper. This is so I can utilize this water that I'm putting on the paper, along with the water that I'm mixing into the paint on the palette to get it light enough. Now, one of the first rules of painting blonde hair is always mix purple into your yellow. And depending on how bright you want it, you might mix just a little bit, or you might mix quite a lot. Now, hair can't be all one color unless you're painting a cartoon. So I went back to the same color that I'd used after the base was on, and just with less water in the brush, so it will be darker, I painted on low lights, which just means that I painted on a darker color than the base. In my preparatory sketch, I'd drawn in the lines of how the hair flowed, so I just followed those lines with my low lights, and that helped give the hair texture. I see a bit of blue in this, so I've mixed black into the Prussian blue that was already on my palette. And I was about to go and put this on the paper until I remembered a very important rule when painting portraits. When using bright colors, blue, red, etc., always mix their complements into them. You want muted versions of these colors, not bright ones. So I mixed a bit of orange into my blue, and then I put it on the paper. Now, I'd forgotten to press record for this, but after I went and compared the painting to the reference photo again, I noticed I painted one of the streaks, one of the blue streaks, too big. And watercolor isn't easy to paint over, but I decided to try layering orange over the blue to neutralize it, and then just paint the same yellow over that. Then I decided that the yellow, even though I'd mixed purple into it, it was still too bright, so I just wetted my paper down and dipped my brush into a little bit of purple, just had a little bit of it on the edge, and I just layered that all over where I had yellow. Even in this woman's very light hair, there are some parts that are still pretty dark. So I mixed the same blue that I used before into some brown, and I mixed that into the same yellow that I used before, which was yellow mixed with purple. And I'm painting that now on very thin streaks using my smallest filbert brush. I'm taking care to make sure these are the right shape, which is really tapered at the top and gets thicker going down, and at least approximately in the right places. If you just put streaks or lines in randomly, it won't work. If you were doing this in oils or acrylics, the process would be pretty much the same, except of course that you would use white to lighten your color, and you would blend out your edges with your brush as you went along, instead of relying on the water to do your lightening and blending. And I know it really doesn't show in the video, but these streaks came out too bright. Really, I thought they came out almost too mustardy, so I'm going over them with purple to neutralize them. I'll have affiliate links for everything that I'm using in the description. Here's my painting of Kate Moss from the 2005 CFDA Awards. This is actually the first time that it occurred to me to mix purple into the yellow to tone it down and not make it so bright. But still, for her underlayers, I used burnt sienna, which is pretty dark compared to the yellow that I was using. Blonde hair comes in a vast array of shades. That was just one type. I chose that particular shade, though, for this demonstration because I thought it would be a challenge for me, and I like challenges. But also, it's about as far from yellow as you can get, and when most people are starting to paint, I thought this way, oh, blonde hair, just paint it yellow. But it's usually not the case, and this photo just allowed me to demonstrate that to, I think, a very good effect. I make videos with art demos and tips every week, so if that sounds good to you, click here to subscribe for absolutely free, and I'll see you again next time. Bye!